isn't it? It doesn't look as if it's so deep, but it could still cause problems.
That's tough. You know, I don't think Tony Johnson's arm can fit under anyone's throat.
That's a big arm to get under there. It's there now, though.
Watch out for your head and groin, okay? No hit to the back of the head and the spine. I want a clean, fair fight.
Dark World.
Tony Johnson's probably going to rely on that heavy wrestling base at some point here, but it's going to be interesting to see how long he wants to stand and trade with Loctiv. Feels confident that his hands have gotten better.
Oh, what a good right.
Man, Loctiv rocked him. He missed that shot.
And he's holding on for dear life, isn't he, Johnson? He really did get rocked.
Oh, he got labeled.
Just trying to get his head to clear, I think, Tony Johnson. What an explosion that was from the Australian.
Tony's going right back. He said, I was going to knock this guy out, but
he's
you know
done
what?
Well.
Let me just take him down in my safe zone.
Well, he did exactly the right thing, didn't he? Gave himself a bit of time to recover while putting pressure on his opponent and ends up in the advantageous position.
Well, you know, Johnson trains at American Kickboxing Academy with some very, very tough guys. Cain Velasquez and all those guys over there. So he gets hit by guys that are big and strong.
Doesn't get much heavier and better than that, does it?
No, Cain Velasquez is a beast.
Laktoff showed some good speed there just to get out of range as Tony Johnson, who we've talked about being quick, he's a sprinter in his younger days perhaps, but he'll clearly have fast twitch muscle fibers, and he threw out a snappy right hand there, but the Australian did well just to jump out of range. So also very quick for two big men.
You know, Loctiv throwing another big right hand. You know, Loctiv on paper looks a lot like a younger Tim Sylvia. He kind of has that big flat-footed, I'm just gonna throw one, two big punches at you and knock you out with my titanium right hand.
Doesn't need any more than one or two, does he? Just missed Johnson by a whisker there.
But Johnson felt that power. It's gonna be interesting to see if Johnson wants to kind of be a little more. Oh, he got another tag on the chin there. It's gonna be interesting to see how this really affects Johnson's game plan after feeling that power. Oh, and he got rocked again.
Now he's going to do the same thing again. He's looking to grasp, but this time he takes a knee to the head, and he's still looking to grasp the legs. Really is doing very well in this situation, Johnson. Clearly been there before and knows how to deal with it. But how many times can he take punches like that? There's only 3 minutes gone in this contest.
Yeah, you keep getting that light switch flickered on and off. That's going to go off at some point. Got to be real careful. But there's a lot of guys out there that constantly get rocked in fights, and you just can't put them away. I mean, Eddie Alvarez, you look at his fights, I think every single fight he's ever had, he's eaten. He even tells the refs sometimes beforehand that I'm gonna get rocked, so just let me do my thing, okay? You know, and some guys can just take punches. You know, that also gets frustrating for Loctiv if he feels like he's connected with some really solid shots and he's buckled Johnson but can't put him away. That'll start to wear on your psyche after a while. Like, man, I keep hitting this guy with everything and he's not going down.
When Johnson leans on him like this, it wears on your body as well. This must be tough for the Australian to have this big man leaning in on him and pressing him up against the cage. Not giving him any of the leverage that he wants to unleash those big bombs that we've seen already. Good knee work again from Loctiv. We saw him connect with Johnson's head earlier. Going for the legs there. Referee breaks them up to bring them back to center cage, and a lot of appreciation for that in this arena because they've enjoyed what they've seen so far when they've been standing up and striking. Who's to say we won't see more?
I got a feeling we're going to see more.
I'm with you.
Johnson's hands are a little bit low here. Oh, looks like he may have caught a little head action. Johnson's doing what he needs to do. I mean, he is setting up that takedown off of those punches. But man, does he know that Loctiv hits hard. This is very similar to how Tim Sylvia used to fight when he was the two-time UFC champion. You know, he's just had heavy hands, kind of anti-wrestling. really relied on just putting those couple punches down the pipe, exploited that reach.
A lot of movement from the waist up, lateral movement from Loktev.
A couple of good punches coming in from Loktev.
As Johnson was backing off, though, he took the sting out of those punches.
Whoa! Nice double leg off of that kick. Well, Loktev's a purple belt in jiu-jitsu. See if he can work on that Kimura. But Tony Johnson's just a powerhouse. It's going to be hard for him to yank that out and finish from here.
It's the left arm you need to be looking at of Johnson.
Let's go, guys. Improve position.
Working with the right, but it's the left arm potentially where the Kimura might happen. It slipped away. Now, Ken Johnson gained some advantage from this after having had a tough first round, laying in those heavy hands of his. And both big bangers, not just the Australian. Good elbow work from the American.
You know, and it's odd because you don't usually see a lot of guys that are this big work off of their back, because in the gym, I mean, there's just not physically that many guys that are going to put you there because you're so much bigger. You're 40, 50 kg bigger than the average guy you're training with. So it's interesting to see when guys that are this big, like Frank Mir and Loktev, if he can work off of his back and be very effective from this position, especially when you have a guy like Tony Johnson, who's very high-level wrestler on top of you and can smell out those submissions from a mile away.
It's good work from Tony Johnson with his fists and his elbows. Staying busy on top.
He is staying busy. Got to be careful constantly extending those arms. It's very frustrating too when you have wrestlers who have a tremendous sense of balance and pressure and base. It looks like they're just sitting there, but see how Tony's up on his toes. He's constantly keeping pressure into Loktev, and it's very difficult to move. You create a couple of inches of space and you're able to slice through and get to a better position. You see there Tony is able to pass into half guard now.
Just over the halfway mark in this contest. 3 5-minute rounds. Judges score the fight in its entirety. They don't look at it on a round-by-round basis. Johnson's corner being encouraged, or rather encouraging their man to keep that pressure on. And it's been a good round for him. Having difficulty with that hand in the throat, though. As if that might do the trick for the Australian for a while there.
Oh, Tony Johnson now hopping onto the back, taking a page out of Peter Davis's book.
Can he get that arm under? Doesn't look as it. Yeah, there he is. He has another go for it.
And he might fall off here. Oh, he's going to give up his back. Oh, there's some blood somewhere.
There's blood coming out.
Let's see if Tony Johnson can finish this.
It's not. It's around the chin, isn't it? Doesn't look as if it's so deep, but it could still cause problems.
That's tough. You know, I don't think Tony Johnson's arm can fit under anyone's throat.
That's a big arm to get under there. It's there now, though. It's under that chin, and we might not be. 55 seconds left. That's plenty of time to work this one out.
That's pretty deep. I don't know if it's going to be. It's hard to see from this angle exactly how much. Oh, Tony let it go, though.
Yeah, he did.
When you feel like you've got those chokes, you give yourself 120% squeezing on those things. But if you miss it or you were wrong and you thought it was deeper than it was, that lactic acid buildup in your arms is horrendous.
The soccer kicks doing some damage. And Tony Johnson's in a bit of trouble down there. Back and forth, this contest has gone.
Been a great heavyweight fight, back
it
and
really
forth.
Really has.
You know, I actually know guys that during fights, they know how bad the lactic acid will build up on your opponent. So when a guy feels like he's going for a choke, they'll pretend like you've almost got it. They'll start making noises and start wheezing so the guy just burns out his arms. So 18-2 in the cage. Both guys are usually on the winning side of decisions or any of the fights. Lokdiv doesn't show any signs of slowing down, but we thought that Johnson may have the upper hand if it goes the distance, having just been such an athlete his whole life.
So Lokdiv is in unknown territory, never been into the third round of a contest in his mixed martial arts career. How will he adapt to that?
That was a nice sprawl.
Oh, just missed with the soccer kick to the head. Wow, there couldn't have been much more than a millimeter in that. How this fight could have changed if that had landed solidly.
Got an odd feeling this is not going to go the distance.
Come on, guys. Come on, let's go.
Well, it's become it's slowed down a little bit, hasn't it? They were both a little bit more fidgety in the stand-up in the first two rounds. Of course, that's quite understandable. And this is where mistakes can be made. You can expose yourself to a big punch from your opponent.
Let's go, guys. Action. Come on.
Once the fatigue sets in.
A couple of nice shots again by Lokdiv, kind of glancing off of the chin of Johnson.
Tony's bleeding from the nose.
Come on, finish. Again, let's go.
Oh, just misses with the uppercut. You know, getting those takedowns is almost as tiring as missing those takedowns, having to fight them off and use up a lot of energy.
Johnson's takedowns, or the double leg takedowns, come from counter movements. They counter the leg kicks, they counter the punches. He's clearly very well schooled at doing that.
Well, he's timing to set it up. That's the key. He's also shooting from the right range. You know, they tell you in wrestling, if you can't touch your opponent, you really shouldn't shoot on him. You can't cover so much space. Let's see if Tony has the energy here to finish or not. Tony's corner is yelling at him, he's gotta work. It's gonna be a very, very tough fight to call here if this does go to the scorecards.
Directly above us here at cage side.
Tony's going to try to pull those legs out from under Lokdiv and finish that double leg, but he looks a little bit slow here, a little bit tired, obviously, as the round starts going on. You got 300 pounds of someone just grinding on you.
All right, guys, break. All right, ready?
That's not a good sign when the referee breaks you in the position you want to get to.
Yeah.
Tony works very hard to get to the single leg there and then wasn't able to finish it. Selmy's starting to slow down with that gas tank.
Olivier Costa, referee from France.
Let's go, finish it. Let's go, finish it.
Less than 2 minutes to go in this one now. And the unlikely event of this one going to the scorecards is looking more and more likely.
Come on, walk to finish. Take your white
down. Who'd have thought that 15 minutes ago?
Well, 13 minutes, 30 seconds down. Got a minute and a half left, and Lokdiv moves to Tony's back now. He's gonna try to work off of the back and throw some hooks in. Put his feet on the inside of Tony's hips, maybe.
Oh, the punch and then the soccer kick.
That's one thing that I'm almost positive that AKA doesn't train for, because most of the guys there fight in the US, is that when you're down on your knees, having to defend your face to those kicks. Something you're not used to doing, you can definitely be susceptible to taking a shot there that you just didn't see coming.
He took it right on the nose and then had a dab at his nose afterwards. There may have been some damage done there. Good left hand from Lokdiv, right on the button. It was wristy, so it didn't bother Johnson so very much.
Come on, finish it, 30 seconds.
Lenny Hart calls the final 30 seconds of this contest.
See Tony Johnson looking up at the clock.
Can't really blame him.
on, work it, work it, work it.
This one is going to go the distance, and it's the judges who will determine the winner.
Olakau's going to try to get a takedown now, just to try to solidify the win.
Judge number one sees it for Loktev. Judge number two has it for Johnson. And judge number three, for your winner, via split decision, Chris Igor Loktev!
Well, that's the way we thought it would go, but a split decision gives Tony Johnson a little bit of encouragement to take home. It was a cracking contest. I really can't disagree with the judges' verdict.